हेलो लॉस प्रिंस, वोकैबुलरी और बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक्स ऑफ लैंग्वेज इज समथिंग विच विल रियली एनहांस योर वोकैबुलरी. इट विल बी अ फेदर इन योर कैप. द स्टूडेंट्स हैव बीन टेलिंग मी, मैम यू हैव बीन यूजिंग अ लॉट मेनी idioms. योर लैंग्वेज ओवरफ्लोज विद idioms, वोकैबुलरी, synonyms, antonyms. सी डियर, इट happens विद टाइम. When you've been speaking and using the language very often, so it keeps going on and on. We've been doing the routes as per your demand, and we had taken 3 routes day before yesterday, no more 3, and I had to continue with the route 4 again. So writing up the next route, that is 4, continuing with it. In fact, the last class I left it at the same juncture. I had started with the root dior yesterday, then I turned to the 4 root, that was strong. These were the words I did yesterday for the root 4. It is a fortress, it's a fortification, it's an effort, it's a reinforcing thing, making something very strong. I had also taken up the further slide in this, that is something which is forceful or fortifying, comfortable with something, right, or fortitude. And then I turn to the next words of 4. Now the word comfort, as I was telling that I am at home or comfortable with vocabulary, what I mean is that I can do things in a proper way. I'm too much, you know, comfortable means at ease, easily I can do that thing. Is a thoroughly strong feeling, right? Next word, that is, see the foreign word, pianoforte. Pianoforte is a soft sound and strong as it loud sound instrument. एक ऐसी loud sound है which is soft sound and strong. Both things juxtaposition in simultaneous form. This is called in English juxtaposition. You've been using this word simultaneously very often. It's a synonym of the word. So the soft sound and the strong as the loud sound instrument, because instrument is very loud, so it is soft as well as it is strong. Okay. Next word, 40. 40 is a strong sound, a loud sound. Fortissimo. See, break the word into 2 syllables. Fortissimo. It's a strong, very strong sound. You know, if I were to say the word ear piercing. See, the words are very interesting in English if you take interest in them. Something which is ear-piercing sound or trumpet sound. It's very loud. It's something you would not like to hear. Something like, you've heard the root caco? That is bad. And phon, that is sound. So, cacophonous would be very bad sound. Very loud sound is, of course, you nobody would like that sound. Fortified, from this root, the strong thing, making something very strengthened, very strong. Effortless is not requiring any strength to do. And the word 40 is strong points in someone's ability. See, every person has an Achilles heel, just opposite of this word, just opposite. This is the weak point, and every person has strong point. So Achilles heel opposite, it was just, you know, erased from it, so I write it again. This is an antonym of this, and so this is strong point. We all have our strong points, our plus points, you know, our merits, right? Which is like feather in the cap, to use the idiom again. Yes, okay. Let's turn to the next route for today. The route is very simple, that is man. Man means hand, right? Manicure or manipulate or manual or manufacture or manage, all by hand. Manipulate, you change by hand. It's more often used for a changed part. Change. Of course, your hand works in making that change. Manual, which can be operated by hand. You know, you have, when you're using a machine, you have to use a manual properly, right? Manufacture is made by hand, right? This is manufactured. manage. You know, some things are managed. Some you have to manage your questions properly. Means you have to make a arrangement or lead by your hand. Maneuver. Maneuver is a person who works by hand, usually a very laborious or a stalwart person. Used for laborious. Used for stalwart. Used for somebody who is working by his hand. Manners is social handiness, which is expected, the basic etiquettes that we have. Sophistication, how to behave. It should make it sophistication, right? Okay. Next word in this, manure. Manure is the animal fertilizer which is spread by hand. You know, this is the diasporic situation where the farmer, you know, spreads up the seeds. That is manure, animal fertilizer. Manicure is taking care of the hands. You take care of the hands in a proper way. That is manicure. Manacle is a restraint that binds the hands. You have some limitation in your hand and you bind the hand. That is manacle. Emancipation. That is freedom. So when we have this word, I really had discussed in my offline classes too, and I really want to bring out this synonym for you. See this word. Emancipation is freedom. Free. Liberty. We talk of in our age of feminism and emancipation of women, that is freedom. When we have the same word without P, emanciation, this means thin, slender, weak, feeble. Somebody who doesn't have the strength to do something, that is emanciation. Emancipation free and emanciation is very thin. Manuscript. You know, so you will be talking about the emancipation of India, how India got freedom and things happened. Manuscript, so we have the root here. S-C-R-I-P, that is right. We have gram and graph. Also meaning in the sense of write. All three roots meaning write. So manuscript is a handwritten document. You know, many times you are asked your resume in a manuscript form. That means in a handwritten form. Right? Okay. Next root is really very interesting. That is sip. Sip is to take something. If I would say by force, on your own wish, deliberately, purposely, or by, you know, vehemently, depends on the use. First word, concept. Concept, you'll be wondering, some of them have S-C-E-P and some have C-A-P. So, we just put an oblique to it so that things are accessible for you. So, make it C-E-P also and C-A-P too. Right, so this would make up the basic root here, CIP, CEP and CAP. Concept is thoroughly taken or seized in one's brain. You have put it in your brain. This is kind of a concept. Intercept is taken from the beginning, something you start from the initial state. This is called a kind of an yes, exposition. He is capable, that is able to take something and work efficiently with it, do things in a proper, in a systematic way, that is capable. Capacity is amount that can be taken. Incapacitated is not able to take in life's arrows. You know, sometimes we are all loaded with life's problems, tensions, and we are burdened with them and we cannot come out of those problems of life, and that is incapacitated. Right? So, this is a concept which you seize, which you have to put in your mind. You know, when we say the word grasp in your mind, you have to comprehend. And exposition is taken the beginning, from the beginning sense. Capable is to take something, work efficiently or effectively for this. Capacity is the amount that you take for this. Incapacitated is to take, not able to take in life's problems, life's tensions. You know, you are loaded with life's problems and you're not able to come out of those tensions and problems. Next word, that is the word recipient or recipient. You can see SCIP loaded here, right? So when we have recipient is one who takes something back towards herself. Anybody who takes the thing back on him is a recipient. Incipient is taken it at the beginning. Yes, from the start, from the scratch. Yes. Principle is the moral standard taken first. It's the, you know, the difference, I think, between the school principal. Not to talk of this scenario. This is any law or a code of conduct. He is my disciple. That means my student, pupil, follower. I am the mentor. So one who takes in knowledge given by the teacher is disciple. Conceive is to take an idea thoroughly, completely. You take that idea in your mind. You conceive it. See, perceive, conceive, receive. The three rhyming words. All the three means the same. You take an idea. I write it here. Take the idea in your mind completely. Deceive. Don't deceive anyone's, you know, break someone's trust. This is deceive. In simple word, it means cheating or forgery or cunning. And when somebody trusts you and you break that trust, what is that one word for it? Yes, it is embezzlement. Somebody trusts you and you break the trust of someone, you deceive someone, you throw dust into someone's eyes. This is deceive and this is embezzlement. Right? Thoroughly, completely, fully you do that. Perceive, that means you take someone's surroundings, what is around you, you see that. I'd given you these three rhyming words, conceive, perceive and receive. That means you take into someone what is around you, receive from your receptors. Your sense organs play a pivotal role in getting the things in your mind and you grasp that concept, you hold it tightly in your mind, and that is what it means. So you can remember the words very carefully. They can be, you know, linked with the words, the sentences. Like if I would say he was the sentence I could make is very quickly is the comes which comes, you know, in instantly to my mind. Rabindranath Tagore was a recipient of the Nobel Prize in 1913, the first Indian for literature, and he has been very incipient in taking up the deal. This, the principal formula of success is hard work, which is the key to success. He is my disciple and I am the mentor. Please conceive, perceive or receive the things in a proper scenario and don't try to break someone's trust or deceive someone. Like, life is short, so live with these words so that you don't face any problem while understanding, comprehending, grasping and getting the gist of the comprehension. Yes, the gist of the comprehension. Thank you.